ragaratnamalika cherangillu natahari shataragaratnamalika cherangillu natahari shataragaratnamalika ranjullu nadahari shataragaratnamalikache 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 ranjullu nadahari shataragaratnamalika che ye bagasevilchi sakala bagasevilchi sakala bhagasevilchi sakala bhagyamandura murare bhagasevilchi sakala bhagyamandura murare bhagasevilchi sakala bhagyamandura murare ragaratnamalikache ranjillu natahari shataragaratnamalikache नैगम षट् शास्त्र पुराण आगमार्थ सहितमट नैगम षट् शास्त्र पुराण आगमार्थ सहितमट योगी वरुलु ఆనందమును ఉందే సన్మార్గమట యోగి వరులు ఆనందమును ఉందే సన్మార్గమట భాగవతోత్తములు గూడి పాడే కీర్తనములట భాగవతోత్తములు గూడి పాడే కీర్తనములట త్యాగరాజు కడతేర తారకమణి చేసిన త్యాగరాజు కడతేర తారకమణి చేసిన శతరాగరత్నమాలికచ్చే రంజిల్లు నడగరి శతరాగరత్నమాలికచ్చే రంజిల్లు నడగరి శతరాగరత్నమాలికచ్చే గ్రీటింగ్స్. This presentation is about Ragamalikas in Carnatic music concerts. In South Indian art forms that are related to music, Ragamalikas appear in many different allied art forms, such as, of course, in dance, such as Bharatanatyam or Kuchipudi, Mohiniyattam, Kathakali, and so on. It is quite natural to have Ragamalikas because different ragas will be employed to express different moods in the Abhinaya. And similarly, in musical theater like Yakshagana or in dramas, let's say 100 years ago, where there were mostly musicals or movies, there are lots of Ragamalikas. Also, in light devotional music, bhajans and harikatha and all that, Ragamalikas would be employed. So we will not be looking at any of those things. We are going to focus only on Ragamalika compositions in Carnatic music concerts. Within Carnatic music concert also, there are, of course, Ragamalikas that appear in two ways. One is an extempore improvisation, kalpana or manodharma sangeetam, such as when you hear Ragamalika swaras being sung, especially in Ragam Tanam Pallavi, you would see that at the end, or when shloka is being sung in different ragas and so on. So we will not be looking into those aspects, manodharmam, much. But we will be focusing on compositions, that is songs with multiple ragas. And even in songs, there are two ways. One is that the lyrics were written by somebody, perhaps an ancient composer like Purandaradasa or Annamacharya and so on, which have been set to Ragamalika tunes by modern musicians. We will not be looking at them. I'll mention them briefly as we go, but mostly we will be focusing on compositions that were meant to be Ragamalikas, and where the lyrics and the music were both made by the same person, Vaggeyakara. So we'll limit our scope to that so that we can finish this in a reasonable amount of time. Now, Ragamalika itself could be translated, the word can be translated as a garland of ragas, which means a composition that has multiple ragas. So you might wonder what's there to talk about it much, but you will see there are so many varieties of expressions of this basic idea in different compositions that our musical composers have developed over several centuries. So we are going to first go through a brief history of the origin and evolution of Ragamalikas as we know it today. And then I will walk you through the various aspects in a Carnatic music concert today. And we will see that Ragamalikas actually permeate every one of those items in a Carnatic music concert. So Ragamalikas are not just something that you sing at the end of a concert, but it's permeates throughout, all the way from Varnam to Mangalam, you will see Ragamalikas. And in many different formats that composers have employed. So we will start with some history and some little bit of geography as well as to how the concept of Ragamalikas has evolved over several centuries. So we will start from this near Aurangabad in Maharashtra, this Ellora caves where Sarangadeva lived. And so around the turn of the between 12th and 13th centuries. So we will start from there, moving down to then both in space and time to Vijayanagara Empire, during which time there was also a lot of activity in the Udupi Mangalore area by Haridasas, and also near Tirupati by Annamacharya. And then going further down to the Tanjavur area, where there was a lot of development in Ragamalikas. And going further down to Ramanathapuram, Ettayapuram, and Thiruvananthapuram areas, where there have been quite a few contributions. And then moving up to 20th century, where of course the majority of the activities happens near Chennai or around this area, and also in Mysore, supported by the Mysore Palace. So this is the area we will be covering in our brief history of Ragamalikas. So we'll start with Sarangadeva, who lived from 1175 to 1247. He was a Kashmir Brahmin, and as the Muslim invasions of North India were increasing in frequency, many artists were starting to move down south, and his family was one of those, wandered around North India, and then finally he settled in a place near Aurangabad. Even today they have a Sarangadeva festival every year in Aurangabad. And so he has written one of the most influential musical treatises in Indian music, called Sangeeta Ratnakara. And in that text, where he collected all of the available information at his time about various aspects of classical music. And this was, mind you, before the bifurcation of Indian classical music into Hindustani and Carnatic. So before the Persian influence and the bifurcation. So in fact, both North Indian and South Indian musicians refer to Sangeeta Ratnakara in musicology. So there is the compositions are referred to as Prabandha. Prabandha means that which is structured. Bandha means is bound, typically by a Dhatu and a Matu. Dhatu means the music, which consists of both melody and rhythm. And Matu is the lyrics. So Prabandha, and there are many types of Prabandha, and Prabandha has different steps of evolution. So Prabandha, he uses the word Raga Kadambakam, which means the same thing as Ragamalika today. And in that section on Prabandha, he refers to several types of Raga Kadambakam. For example, Sarabalila is a composition with 8 ragas and 8 talas. And you can read the list. Sri Vilasa, Sri Ranga, Uma Tilaka, and Panjabangi, with different numbers of ragas and talas. So these were known even then. That means, of course, whenever we write grammar or musicology type books, that means these forms have already existed even before that. So he lists these things. So that, so Ragamalikas have a very ancient history. The Prabandhas of those time have now evolved into the kind of songs, kritis and kirtanas that we employ today in Carnatic music. So next big development happens around the 15th, 16th centuries in the Udupi area, where Sri Padaraya, this is of course the Haridasa movement with great teachers like Sri Padaraya and Purandaradasa and so on. And Sri Padaraya was also the inventor of a type of musical item called Suladi. Suladi typically has multiple ragas and talas like we saw, but in a structured way. This is what Purandaradasa, in organizing musical teaching, he shows the Sapta Talas, right? Dhruva, Matya, Rupaka, Triputa, Jampa, Atatala, and then Ekatala, 7 Talas. So Sri Padaraya is supposed to have composed hundreds of Suladis. And Sri Purandaradasa also has composed some of them. And some of the shuladis composed by them are in, so the different sections are not only in different talas, but also in different ragas. But we don't have, of course, the original music. There are some manuscripts available with a couple of shuladis of Sri Padaraya and one shuladi of Purandaradasa, where it is indicated that each section would be in a different raga and different tala. At the same time, Annamacharya in the Tirupati area, he is in fact, as you can see from the age, he is a little bit older than even Sri Padaraya, but he, the Suladis primarily was the possession of Kannada composers, but Annamacharya also seems to have borrowed that idea. And we know of at least one Suladi by him, which is a Ragamalika. It's referred to as Desi Suladi. And it has seven ragas and seven talas. So the seven talas that I mentioned to you are what we learn in basic Alankaram exercises. And these are the ragas that were mentioned. Fortunately, in the case of Annamacharya, many of his compositions were inscribed on copper plates and stored. So all those copper plates were, of course, now recovered and then set to music by musicians through the Annamacharya project. And this Desi Suladi was resurrected by Professor S.R. Janakiraman. So since the raga names were mentioned in those copper plates, so he constructed the music. Of course, we don't know the original tunes, because even within a raga, you can have many, many different tunes. So based on the music prevalent at that time, his knowledge of that, Professor Janakiraman is one of the most renowned musicologists of our times. And he resurrected this in 1978 and presented to the Music Academy. So we have, but we don't have the original tunes, of course, of these ancient Ragamalika compositions. The next big contribution comes in the 17th century, but in the Tanjore Maharashtrian kingdom by Shahaji Maharaj. And in his rule, Tanjore was at the zenith of its power under the Maratha rule. And he was, looks like not only a great ruler and a statesman, but also brilliant, both in literary contribution as well as in music. So this is what is of interest to us. He composed many prabandhas for Yakshagana. Yakshagana, in those days, there was a lot of contributions from Tanjore, a lot more musical than dialogue. And so for the purpose of our discussion, there are two Ragamalikas here that are of interest. One is with 14 ragas. He named it Chaturdasha Bhuvana Anuraga Ragamalika Daru. Daru is a kind of item that is used in musical theater, in dance, dramas, and so on. And so 14 ragas. And those of you who are a little bit knowledgeable about this, you will see the echo of this a little later in one of the later Ragamalika compositions. Another one that he did was a Ragamalika in seven ragas, all of them with the name ending in Gaula. So this was done back in 17th century. We have some Ragamalikas today in the 20th and 21st centuries where people are focused on this idea. And he did that way back in 17th century. And he called it the Sapta Sagara. Some books call it as Sapta Salaga. Suladi Prabandha Leela Daru. And around the same time, there was also a great composer, Sarangapani, Padams. In fact, even today, his Padams are used in dance performances. He lived in Karveti Nagaram. In fact, some of Sarangapani's Padams are mistaken to be Kshetraya's Padam, who was also around the same period. And so he has one padam, which has got 13 ragas. And then coming down to the 18th century, we have some, in fact, many articles start from here. Melattur Veerabhadrayyar, in the Tanjavur area, he was a great innovator, very brilliant man, and all of his compositions were primarily for dance performances. And so he is the inventor of the Swarajati item, it seems. His Swarajati is considered to be the first one. This Yemai Ladira is even now, it is seen and heard in dance performances. The Talam should be Rupakam. This Swarajati is used even today. And then comes Ramaswamy Dikshitar, who, even though he is a few years older than Melattur Veerabhadrayyar, he learnt musical compositions, how to compose, the art of composing from him. Of course, Ramaswamy Dikshitar came from a very illustrious family himself. But the art of composing, he learned from Melattur Veerabhadrayyar. And Ramaswamy Dikshitar deserves an entire page because he had so many compositions. He is the one who has composed the longest Ragamalika in Carnatic music, 108 Raga Thala Malika. So it has both raga, 108 ragas and 108 thalas. So each line is on one raga and one thala. Natakadi Vidyala. And then there is another one, Manasaveri Tarula. 48 raga, Shiva Mohana Shakti, Samajagamana. All these raga malikas, we at least know about them. And we have the scripts for some of them. And the Nataka, the 108, unfortunately, we don't have all 108. Only 61 or so, 61 or 69 have survived now. I just want to show you the script, of course, in English, of this Raga Thala, 108 Raga Thala Malika. So you see here, Nataka, these, so the Raga name and the Thala name is also underlined. So the first line starts with Nata, Raga. And Dhruva Thala. And so many of you who follow Carnatic music and might be admirers of how Muthuswamy Dikshitar was intelligent enough to put raga names that blend with the lyrics. Well, he learned it from his father. Ramaswamy Dikshitar, if you go through this Raga Thala Malika, there are a lot of brilliant ways he has inserted raga name and thala name into the lyrics, which makes sense as you read the lyrics also. Gaula, and then Matta Thala, and then Varali in Rupaka. So Swarupa Kalita, Swarupaka comes. Bauli, see, all of the jumpa. So each line has the raga name and the thala name. So monumental composition, 108, but we don't have all 108 available today. And Ramaswamy Dikshitar was brilliant in many other ways. He composed many padavarnams, thanavarnams, and kritis. The Kriti form had just started coming, and he was one of the early composers of Kritis. And he was the person who introduced Chittaswarams in Kritis. When you hear some swara passage in some songs, either after Anupallavi or after Charanam or both. So he apparently was the one who introduced that idea. And he has composed Anuloma Pratiloma Daru in the raga called Ganga Tarangini, which means, you know, it's like a palindrome. You read from left to right and right to left, you get the same words. So he has done that in music. And not only that, he has composed an entire Padavarnam using Swarasthanas and Swarakshara. So in Todi, Sariga, Dani, like that, all of those, only the seven swara will be used for the entire composition. So very brilliant man with a lot of contributions. And Muthuswami Dikshitar got all those, all that heritage from him, and then developed it further, especially through his Kritis. And also, I should mention, Ramaswami Dikshitar discovered the Raga Hamsadvani. The first known composition, at least in Hamsadvani, is by Ramaswami Dikshitar. So he is credited with discovering that Raga. So that was the early history. Most of it, of course, you know, we don't have recordings of any of those, or even firmly established notations. Some we do through the efforts of Subrahma Dikshitar, especially for Ramaswami Dikshitar, we have some of those. Now, having seen the early history, I'm going to take you through the concert structure, today's concert structure. We typically start with Varnam, and then we sing some Kritis, heavier songs, and then Ragam Tanam Pallavi is a centerpiece of a full-fledged Carnatic music concept. Then followed by some lighter items, padams, javalis, bhajans, kirtanas, and all that. And of course, Ragamalikas are frequent there. And then there is Tillana and Mangalam. And you will see every one of those items, how the Ragamalikas have been explored with various ideas by different composers. So we'll start with Varnams. So Varnams, there are Tana Varnams and Pada Varnams. So we will start with Tana Varnam, which is more commonly used in Carnatic music concerts. So of course, Patnam Subramanyayyar's Navaragamalika Varnam is perhaps the most famous Ragamalika Varnam with nine ragas. Almost all Carnatic music students would learn this early in when they are learning Varnams. Now, Patnam Subramanyar, of course, was a disciple of Manambu Chavadi Venkata Subbayyar, who was a cousin and disciple of Saint Tyagaraja himself. So he's a second generation disciple of Saint Tyagaraja, and an extremely brilliant musician and a composer. In fact, he is referred to as Chinna Tyagaraja himself, because his compositions are so much like Saint Tyagaraja's compositions themselves. And he lived in the second half of the 19th century. 19th century, yes. In Thiruvayar. He lived mostly in Thiruvayar, but for a few years he lived in Madras teaching Yenadi sisters there, and then he came back. So because he had gone to Madras and come back, so he was referred to as Patnam Subramanyayyar, and that name stuck. He was also referred to as Begada Subramanyayyar because he had such a mastery over the raga Begada. So he was also referred as Begada Subramanyayyar. Anyway, so Navaragamalika Varnam, all of you know very well. So I'm not going to sing that. Let's think about this. How the sequence of ragas, you saw this in Navaragamalika. There is a Shankaravaranam, then there is the Kedaram, then Shankaravaranam, and then Kalyani, Begada. So what's the, how does one think about the sequence of ragas? So there are different ways to think about it. One is the aesthetics, especially if the lyrics also have some meaning and you want to convey the mood of the lyrics, that's one way to choose. And some ragas will show some rasa, some bhava better than others. Then also you want to choose also ragas next to each other. They are not so far apart that they are hard to transition from one raga to another. So that transition should be somewhat smooth. So that's what we mean by adjacent ragas, smooth transition. Sometimes you also want to show contrasting ragas. So that's, you know, just like colors, contrasting colors. You want to have contrasting ragas to create a different mood. So aesthetics plays a large role in choosing the sequence of ragas, and of course varies from composer to composer. But there are also technical reasons to choose a particular sequence, and we will see all of these things. For example, there are what are called ghana ragas. There are five major ghana ragas, and then there are also secondary ghana ragas and all that. So sometimes people will choose a particular set of ragas. The Ganaraga Panchakam here refers to Nate, Gaulai, Arabi, Varali, and Sri. These are the five ragas in which St. Tyagaraja also composed his Pancharatnas. So quite often we will see that sequence followed. Sometimes it's even more interesting technical idea where Grahabedam is used to go to different ragas. I will point out a couple of examples. And then sometimes based on names of the ragas, like we saw Gaulai, all the raga names ending with Gaulai, and we have seen similarly Ranjani or Manohari and Priya, so all the ragas with similar endings, they get used also. So there are different considerations that go into choosing a particular sequence, and varies from song to song and from composer to composer. And so there might be also a mix of aesthetics and technical reasons. So in Thanavarnam, I mentioned Patnam Subramaniayar, and a contemporary of his is a great musician from Mysore, Veena Seshanna. And he has composed many items, and especially varnams with many different thalas. You know, most the varnams you see in concert platforms typically have Aditalam and some in Atatalam. Those are the two most common thalas that we hear in varnams. But he explored many other thalas, such as Mishra Triputa. Mishra Triputa means 11 counts. Sankirna Matyam. Sankirna means 9. So 9, Matyam is Lagu, Dutam and Lagu. So 9 plus 2 plus 9, that's 20 count thala. And you can see here 14 ragas and 21 ragas. So he followed a different format from Patnam Subramaniayar. So you see, Patnam Subramaniayar, we have basically in the first half of the Varnam, you have the, you can say Pallavi and then Anupallavi, and then there are two Muktaiswaras. And then the second half starts, Charanam. So Kamboji is in that refrain, Pada Saroja. And then there are four swaras in each different raga. So Patnam Subramaniayar used one raga for each section of the varna. What Veena Seshanna did is something else. He composed, first of all, like the Kamakoti Sundaranguda is in Behag, starts with Behag. So we have an entire varnam in Behag, so all the first half and even second half, charanam and swaras, four swaras. And then he adds 13 other ragas, swaras in 13 other ragas. And same thing in Mahishasura Samharini. It starts with Begada, and then you can say an entire varnam is done, and then all these ragas are added, swaras in these ragas are added towards the end. So it's a different format. And then there are other Ragamalikas, Varnams. Kalahasti Venkatasami Raju, his Navaghana Ragamalika is what I was telling you. You see here, the first half has these four ragas, Nata, Gaulai, Varali, and Arabi. And then Sri starts the second half, and then you have these are called the secondary Dutiya Ganaragas, Narayana Gaula, Riti Gaula, Bauli, and Kedaram. So his Navaghana Ragamalika Varnam. And similarly, Nerur Srinivasa Acharya. Nerur is also associated with the great saint music composer Sadashiva Brahmendra. So he has composed a Varnam in 10 ragas, as you can see. And then in the 20th century, we have also Professor Sambamurthy, one of the greatest musicologists in Carnatic music in the 20th century. He started pretty much the modern musicology. He taught at various colleges in Madras University and so on, and really revolutionized the way we think about music theory in Carnatic music, and did great contributions. And he has also composed items. So we will see Ashtaragamalika Varnam. So there is a Varnam by him in 8 ragas.
Ragamalika Varnamu Bhavamutonu Padare Dinaragamalika Varnamu Unuraga Bhavamutonu Padare Rakti ragamulaina bilagaridanyasi madhyamavati kalyani purva kalyani kedaragula moganu bhupalamu lugal ragamulaina bilagaridanyasi madhyamavati kalyani purva kalyani kedaragula moganu bhupalamulugala pamariri mapamariri sanisarisa sanipamapanisariri Rimari pama pama ni basani sani risari mari sani bamari sa isari mapani raga malika varnamu nu raga bavamutonu padare rakti raga mulaina bilagari danyasi madhyamavati kalyani purva kalyani kedara gola moganu bhupalamulugalapa pamariri mapamariri sanisari sasani pamapani sariri rimari pamapamani pasani saniri sari mari sani pamari sani sari mapani ragama alika varnamu Ashtaragamalika Varnamu Ashtaragamalika Varnamu Pamagari Sanida Sariga Mapadapa Ashtaragamalika Varnamu Nidav pa magari ma pa magari magari sa sa ni da pa ni sa ri magari ma pa ni da pa ma pa ni sa ri magari sa sa ni da pa magari sa ri ma pa ni ashta ragamalika varnamu sa sa da pa ga ga da pa ga pa ga ri sa sa da pa da sa ri ga pa ga pa da ri sa ga ri pa ga ri sa da pa da ri sa da pa ga ri ri ga pa da ashta ma ga ma li ka varnamu sa da pa ga ga da pa ga ga ri ri sa sa da sa ri ga pa ga pa da pa ga pa da pa ga ga da pa ga ga ri ri sa sa ri ga ga da pa ga ga ri ri sa 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 da pa da sa ri ga pa da pa ga ri sa ri ga pa da pa ga ri ga pa da sa da pa da sa ri ga pa ga ri sa da pa ri sa da pa ga ri ga pa da ashta ragamalika varnamu ashta ragamalika.
So he even gives all the names of the ragas in the Anupallavi. Another interesting varnam is a Priya Ragamalika by Srimati Suguna Purushottaman. She was a great musician, particularly specialized in singing Pallavis with complicated talas, and she could do two talas, one in one hand and one in the other hand. Of course, both will converge with the same count. So, very accomplished person in the music field over the past century. And one of her beautiful compositions is the Priya Ragamalika Varnam. So in this, as you can see, all the raga names end with the Priya phrase. So just a glimpse, I won't have time to sing all of it, but
Sankara hara priya uma kumara sharana adaide sharavana bhava aikarayane kilaya gana priya da nida pamagari sa nida,
like that it goes. So all the names of the ragas also appear, at least where the sahityam is. Shanmuga priya also.
Shanmuga priya valli kunjari manala,
like that. So where the sahityam is, the raga name comes in, and the others just swaras. So, also very interesting varnam called Priya Ragamalika Varnam. Then we move on to some examples of Padavarnam. Padavarnam, where you have sahityam for all the sections. Wherever there are swaras, there is also sahityam. Of course, Padavarnams are generally used in dance extensively. In Bharatanatyam, that's the main item. So we will not, there are many Padavarnams, and so there would be many more Ragamalikas than, I'm just going to give you a couple of examples. One is this very famous Ragamalika Varnam by, now there is, I have put two people here. This first one is Ponnaya. He is part of the Tanjavur Quartet. You know, Chinnaya, Ponnaya, Vadivelu, Sivanandam, there are four brothers. They were disciples of Muthuswami Dikshitar, And then they also were supported by Maharaja Swati Thirunal and lived in his court. And so they were prolific composers, and especially for dance. And so he is supposed to be the composer of this. But then also there are some sources that claim that it's not him, but his descendant, K. Ponnaiah Pillai, who was, of course, a great musician and many music compositions. He was Sangeetha Kalanidhi. He was a professor in Annamalai University and so on. So I put both there. Of course, they are in the same family. So this is in Rupakathalam. It starts like this. We obviously won't have time to sing all of it. Sāmi ninne kōrinanura So Todi, and then all the other ragas, as you see in the list, each section in one raga. A great example of a padavarnam, which is still danced to today. And another padavarnam from more recent times is by Sri Lal Gudi Jayaraman. This is one of his young pictures. And அங்கயர் கண்ணி ஆனந்தம் கொண்டாளே ஸ்டார்ட் வித் பிலஹரி நவரச வர்ணம் ஸோ ஈச் ராகா போர்ட்ரேஸ் ஈச் செக்ஷன் போர்ட்ரேஸ் அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ரச வித் மதுரை மீனாட்சி ஆஸ் தி ஹீரோயின் ஆஃப் திஸ் காம்போசிஷன். And similarly, Sri M. V. Narasimhachari, one of the brilliant masters of dance, Bharatanatyam in the past century, not only was he a great singer and composer, but also dancer and choreographer, so and a mridangam player. So he has composed a Padavarnam, Navarasa Ganam, Pirandidume. This is about Sri Rama. And about various incidents in his life and how they show different rasas. Well, the opening one, Shankaravarnam, just introduces the varnam.
Navarasa ganam pirandidume Rama nama mahimai padi ஆடிடவே நவரசகனம்
லைக் தட். திஸ் பதவர்ணம் இட்ஸ் ஹஸ் 11 ராகஸ். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சங்கராபர்ணம் அண்ட் தென் சாரங்கா அண்ட் ஹம்சத்வனி டு கம்ப்ளீட் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஹாஃப் அண்ட் தென் ஷண்முகப்பிரியா ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் அவுட் த செகண்ட் பார்ட். ஷண்முகப்பிரியா அகெயின் டசன்ட் பர்டிகுலர்லி போட்ரே எனி, இட்ஸ் ஜஸ்ட் opening for a refrain for all the other ones.
Ramanin kathamritam perinbame raghu ramanin,
and then all the different verses show, each one shows one rasa like that. So there are some, these are some examples of padavarnams which are ragamalikas. Now before I leave the subject of varnams, there is one very interesting composition. It's a Daru Varnam. In a Daru Varnam, typically you will also have, it doesn't have necessarily Sahitya, but it could have Sahitya also for all the sections like a Padavarnam. In addition to that, you will also have Jatis for the Mukta Iswara. So many of you might have heard Mate Malayadvaja in Kamas by Harikarshan Mutya Bhagavata, which is also a Daru Varnam. So Srimati Charumati Ramachandran, she has composed this Grahabheda Daru Varnam. It's a very brilliant composition. So in this case, it's Grahabheda is employed to go to different ragas. So starts with Mohanam. In fact, all of the first half is in Mohanam, and in the second half also the refrain is in Mohanam. And then come these for the four swara, which is also as Sahitya. These other four ragas obtained by doing Graha Bedam on the swaras of Mohanam come about. So the first half goes like this. In Aditalam.
Moha nanga murali dhara kala dhara man moha nanga murali dhara kala dhara,
like that. And then after the first half, then second half starts.
Rara Sukumara Radha Manohara, Rara Sukumara Radha Manohara.
And then after one Swara and Mohanam, and then you have these four. How do we get through Graha Bedam? If you don't know about Graha Bedam, I have another video on YouTube explaining this Graha Bedam concept. But I'll very briefly go through this. So you have in an octave, sa to sa, you have between sa and sa, you have 12 notes here. And different varieties of ri and ga and so on. So I have put in the swaras for two octaves, because if you're going to shift, you will go into the other octave also. So we'll start with the swara for Mohana.
Sa ri ga pa da sa,
and then the same things in the higher octave. Now I will get Madhyamavati by shifting. This is what graha means, actually the origin. So shifting the origin to another note. So sa, instead of being here, it will shift to here, then it will get Madhyamavati. So if I were to sing the Mohanam swaras,
so then Ri ga pa da sa ri, ri sa da pa ga ri, sa ri ma pa ni sa, sa ni pa ma ri sa.
So this is now Madhyamavati. With ri, Shruti shifted to ri. But we will use sarima panisa, and of course you will only get the different raga if you change the gamakas. If you keep the same gamakas as the starting ragas, it'll just sound like Mohanam in a different scale. So that's how you get these different ragas through Graha Bedam. Hindolam, then Shuddha Saveri, and then Shuddha Danya. Now there is one, I put a star here, because Shuddha Danyasi is the correct name for this raga. But a lot of people use the name Uday Ravichandrika, and she is also used in this composition, Uday Ravichandrika. But Uday Ravichandrika is confusing, because Muthuswami Dikshitar has Uday Ravichandrika as a different raga, where he uses a higher knee, whereas Shuddha Danyasi has a lower knee, which is what is being used here. In fact, he uses a Raga Mudra in compositions of both Uday Ravichandrika and Shuddha Danyasi to clearly distinguish between the two. So that's why I put a star here. Anyway, this composition currently uses the word Uday Ravichandrika. So these are some examples of Ragamalikas and Varnams. And you can see already we saw different formats that different composers have used, and different ideas. Now we come to the main part of the concert, which is typically kritis and kirtanas. Now, first question to ask is a Ragamalika, is it a kriti or is it a kirtana? You see, you have to know the difference between these two. Kirtanas are simple earlier forms, where the focus is more on lyrics, and it's of course singing the glory of God. So devotion is the primary focus. So the tune is very simple and very repetitive. So you'll have a pallavi, which is in simple tune, and then lots of charanams in the same tune. Sometimes even the pallavi and the charanams all will be in only one tune. So we call them ekadatu if there is only one tune for all the verses. Dvidatu if the pallavi is in one tune and the rest of the charanams are in one tune. Those are kirtanas, very simple compositions where the tune is repetitive. So from that point of view, Ragamalika is not a kirtana, because the Ragamalika, obviously the tune is changing, you are changing different ragas, so it is not a kirtana. But then is it right to call it a kriti? Now kriti is typically are very sophisticated forms, musical forms, where the raga is shown in great depth, which is a problem, because Ragamalika typically you have short sections for each raga, so you don't really go deep into any particular raga. So it is also not appropriate to call them kriti. So typically if you look at music books, they'll have Ragamalika as a separate section, the compositions will be listed there. So there is some, but the way I have organized it, there are some Ragamalikas that are heavier, which will typically be sung in the first half of the concert, and then some that are lighter, which would be sung after the Ragam Tana Pallavi. So I've organized it that way. So when we get to the heavier Ragamalikas, of course, one of the best Ragamalikas in Carnatic music is by Muthuswami Dikshitar. It's the Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham Chaturdasha Bhuvana Rupa Ragamalika. If you still remember, Shahaji the second of Tanjavur, he had composed a Chaturdasha Bhuvana Anuraga Ragamalika. So that name seems to have come through in Sri Dikshitar's composition. So there are 14 ragas. I will just sing Pallavi and Anupallavi just to point out the structure. It will take a long time to sing the whole Ragamalika. Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham Chaturdasha Bhuvana Rupa Ragamalika Bharana Dharanantakaranam Shri Vishwanatham Bhajeham Chaturdasha Bhuvana Rupa Ragamalika Bharana Dharanantakaranam Shri Vishwanatham Bhajeham Shrita Jana Samsara Bhitya Pagam Pamagari Sada Pamagari Mama Bhitya Pagam Adhyatmika Dita Patraya Mano Bhitya Pagam Shri Visalakshi Gaurisham Sari Gari Sari Maap Sani Risa Dapa Magari Gaurisham Sakala Nishkala Rupa Sachidananda Maya Gaurisham Chitra Vishwa Nataka Prakasham Pamani Pasani Rizani Bariri Sani Pamari Prakasham Jagat Prakashaka Bhaskara Shashanka Koti Koti Prakasham govindadi vinuta gaulankam pani pani sabani sari rari gamari sa sani pa gaulankam kshira kundendu karpuradi vishaya basito dulita gaulankam guru guga sammohan karalingam pagadadap darisagari sasapadagamohan karalingam panchikrita panchamahabhuta prapanchadi mohan karalingam virinchi vishnu rudra murtimayam vishaya panchakara hitamabhayam niratishaya sukhada nipunataram nigamasaram ishwaram amaram smaragaram paramashivamatulam sarasagridaya hridaya nilaya manisham Sri Vishwanatham bhajeham. So you see, there are a couple of different versions of this song. What I sang is the version that was popularized by Srimati M.L. Vasanthakumari. And so the way this version, you have one raga, Sri Ragam, in the Pallavi, and then five in the Anupallavi, and then eight in the Charanam. That's not a proper arrangement. Usually you would have two, and then four, and then eight. So that is the version which seems to be more closer to the original. That was the version, in fact, I've heard recording of Musri Subramanayar accompanied by M.S. Subbulakshmi singing that version, where they also don't sing the swaras, they just sing the sahitya straight. So Sri and Arabi are sung in the Pallavi, and then the other four are sung in the Anupallavi. But you see the structure here. Now, whichever version it is, after the Anupallavi, each raga is finished, then we have this reverse order going, it's called Vilomam. So in this case, Viloma Sahityam. So all the ragas are being traversed in reverse all the way back to the opening raga, Sri Raga. And same thing will happen in the Charanam after 8. Now he'll reverse back all the way back to Sri Raga. So this is a very interesting construction in Ragamalika compositions. You will see different ways of doing this Vilomam also. So Muthuswami Dikshitar's this Chaturdasha Ragamalika is one of the finest Ragamalika compositions in Carnatic music. And then there are other compositions also. This is, by the way, the postage stamp that was released by the Indian government on the occasion of his bicentennial. And he has also composed three other ragamalikas, Madhavo Mampatu, 10 ragas. And then this one, of course, is Dashavataram. And then Purna Chandra Bimba, this is all of the ragas in that are Janyam of Shankarabharanam. So they are all related to each other. And then Simhasanasthite, which is 4 ragas. So the other two, in terms of the Trinity, Saint Tyagaraja and Shyama Shastri don't seem to have composed any Ragamalikas. So we go on to their disciples and junior contemporaries. One of the great musicians who was a junior contemporary of the Trinity was Todi Sitaramayya. In fact, his name is Todi Sitaramayya, so he had complete mastery over the raga Todi, it seems, and he could sing Todi Alapana for several days at a stretch with so many nuances. And in fact, there is an interesting story that once he was a musician in the court of Sarfoji Maharaja the second in Tanjavur, and so he got into some debt. He had to borrow some money, and as mortgage, he mortgaged his raga todi, meaning he would not sing that raga todi until he repaid the debt. And then there was an occasion where the Sarfoji Maharaja and the English, East India Company high official were getting together, and they arranged for entertainment, and they asked Sitaramir to sing at the occasion. And of course, they asked him to sing todi raga, and he wouldn't sing that. He would sing others, but he would not sing todi. And they kept insisting, but he did not sing todi. Finally, the truth came out. He said, "Well, I have mortgaged todi. I had to take a loan." So immediately, Sarfoji Maharaj said, "Our is the money that he sent somebody with the payment of the loan, repayment of the loan, and freed Sitaramayyar from that debt." And then he sang. So this Sitaramayyar used to have relatives in Thiruvayaru. So he used to visit Thiruvayaru, and whenever he would come, he would meet with Saint Tyagaraja and pay his respects. Tyagaraja also knew that Sitaramayyar was a great renowned musician. So they would meet and talk about music. And on such occasions, Saint Tyagaraja will also sing for him some of his recent compositions. So, in those days, concerts were mainly about ragam tanapalli. So very elaborate singing of raga and tanam and pallavi. So mostly improvisation, maybe one or two short songs here and there. So that was the format then. So it seems that Sitaramayyar remarked on one such occasions, it's not clear whether he remarked directly to Saint Tyagaraja or to one of his disciples, that these compositions are not really suitable for someone like me to sing in concerts. They are more suitable for, he used the word, for ladies to sing in Navaratri Golu and all that. So then on another occasion when he visited Thiruvayaru, he was walking by the street where Tyagaraja's home was, Thirumanjana Vidi. And from inside the house, he heard one very elaborate line, and there was Neraval and Swara going on from one of Tyagaraja's compositions. And he just stopped in his tracks, and he was just amazed at the depth and sophistication of the music of the Neraval and Swaras. And then he went in, and of course, Saint Tyagaraja himself was singing to Lord Rama. There was nobody else. And Sitaramayyar realized his mistake. He fell at his feet and asked for his forgiveness for underestimating Saint Tyagaraja's compositions. And immediately he started learning Tyagaraja's compositions from Veena Kuppayar, one of the senior most disciples of Saint Tyagaraja. And then he popularized those. So he has left one Ragamalika called Nitya Kalyani. Nitya Kalyani Nigamanta Sancharini Atyananda Birama Amarasevita Tripura Sundari Nitya Kalyani. The song was popularized by Ariyakudi Ramanujayengar in the 20th century. So remarkable Ragamalika with 8 ragas, and each verse in one raga, and then swara for that. So you will see the same format followed by many other composers after that. So whereas Dikshitar's Ragamalika had a different structure, this one had 8 different verses, and each verse in one raga and followed by swara. And then another format, this Tarangam Padi Panjanadeyar. This is, of course, a perennial favorite. Even today, you hear this song, Arabhimanam, very frequently. And this has 12 ragas. Now here, the first Pallavi starts with four ragas. And then there are two charanams, also four. So 12 ragas. And then each time, the swaras, just like Sri Vishnuvatam, for the Pallavi, you have the four swaras and four ragas in reverse, coming back to the Arabhimanam Vaitadari Parennai. So come back, so Arabi, then Ananda Bhairavi, then there will be Kalyani, and then Nani and Hamsadvani. So then the swaras will be in Hamsadvani, Kalyani, and Ananda Bhairavi, and then Arabi. And then you have next verse with four other ragas. And so you'll have swaras in those four ragas, and then coming back to Arabhimanam, like that. So there is vilomam, not all the way back to Pallavi, but the vilomam within each verse of swaras, and then returning to the Pallavi. So this was another format. Whereas in the Nitya Kalyani song, each time you sing a particular raga and its swara, and then you come back to the Kalyani, the opening verse. So the different formats were followed. These two are another great favorite. Of course, it's more of a 20th century, early 20th century composition. Ambani nu neranamiti ananda bhairavi. This is also eight ragas. Also popularized by Ariyakudi Ramanujengar. This is a composition of Chinni Krishna Dasar, who is also the composer of that famous Kamas Swarajati Samba Shiva in a way. So these are some Ragamalikas that set different formats for compositions. And then in the 19th century, we also have Ragamalikas by Manambu Chavadi Venkata Subbayar, whom I already mentioned was the guru of Patnam Subramaniar, and he was the cousin and senior disciple of Saint Tyagaraja. He has composed at least a couple of Ragamalikas that we know of, one in nine ragas and one in four. And then Thiruvatriyur Tyagayyar, a brilliant man, great composer. He is the son of Veenai Kuppayyar. And he lived in the Madras area, Georgetown area and all that, and taught a lot of the musicians in that area. So including Veena Dhanamal's family, he taught the music. So he has composed not only a Ragamalika in 16 ragas, but also he has tuned Narayana Teertha's composition, Jai Jai Gokula Bala, which was originally composed all in Kurunji. He tuned it into Ragamalika in five raga, starting with Bhairavi. He has written two books, Pallavi Swarakalpavalli, which contains all of the compositions of his father, Veena Kuppayyar. And then his own compositions are in Sankirtha Ratnavali. So great contribution to Carnatic music. And then, in the 19th century, one of the greatest contributions in the context of Ragamalika is Maharaja Swati Thirunal. Who was a junior contemporary of the Trinity, as you can see. And he has composed many Ragamalikas, 11 Ragamalika compositions that I found. They include a variety of items, Jatiswaram, Kriti, Kirtana, Padam, Shloka, Tillana, all of those are covered. Jatiswaram, his five raga Jatiswaram is very famous in Misra Chapadal. Sani sari sani da padani da bamaga ma padani sa. So Jati Swaram is, and then it is said that one of his famous court musicians, Parameshwara Bhagavatar, who collaborated with him also in some compositions, he put words to it, lyrics to it, and so then it becomes what is called a Swarajati. So such kind of alterations go on for many compositions over the years. And His from the finest Ragamalika and very very well known is Pannagendra Shayana. It was in 8 ragas. I'll sing that for you just to show the structure. This is follows the same structure as Nitya Kalyani, with 8 verses and swaras for each verse, and then. But there is a vilomam at the very end, going all the way back to Shankaravarana. Pannagendra Shayana Shri Padmanabha Mudakama Pannagendra Shayana Shri Padmanabha Mudakama Pannagendra Shayana Shri Padmanabha Mudakama Saunamana Samamava Sarasayata Lochana Pannagendra Shayana Shri Padmanabha Mudakama Saunamana Samamava Sarasayata Lochana Sanidabama Pagamari Garisa Nisariga Mapada Nisarisa Nisada Nisanidabama Gamari Gamabada Nisarisa Nidabada Pamagarisa Nisariga Mapada Nipanagendra Shayana Mandamarutopimama Manasam Vivashayati Mandamarutopimama Manasam Vivashayati Kundakudmalaradana Kopamasu Jahimayi Kundakudmalaradana Kopamasu Jahimayi Sanidabama Badabamaga Mabada Padabadidabama Bada Sarigarisa Sanidabama Pada Sanidabamaga Pada Sarisa Nidabadabamagarisa Nisa Rigama Bada Nipa Nagendra Shayana Kokila Shukadi Manju Kujitamapi Mehanta Kokila Shukadi Manju Kujitamapi Mehanta Pakashasana Vinuta Bhati Goratama Maye Pakashasana Vinuta Bhati Goratama Maye Sanipama Gamariga Ripama Gaza samagamapani satsani papamagamari gamagaza samagamapani sarisani dapadapamagari sanisa rigamabadani panagendra shayana manini janagasita makuruma mangesha manini janagasita makuruma mangesha sunasayaka sadrisha Sunasayaka sadrisha shobhanangadaya para Sunasayaka sadrisha shobhanangadaya ಗದಯವರ ಸಾರಿಸನಿರಿ ನೀದಪ್ಪ ಮಪ ಮಗರಿ ಗ ಮಪದನಿ ಸಾಗರಿ ಸನಿ ಸರಿ ನೀದನಿ ಸರಿ ನೀದಬ ಮಬದನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿದಬದ ಪ ಮಗರಿ ಸನಿ ಸ ರಿ ಗ ಮಬದನಿ ಪ ನಗೇಂದ್ರ ಶಯನ ಯಾಮಿನಿ ಸಂವೇಶಯ ತ್ವಾ ಕಾಮಂ ಅವಲೋಕಯಾಮಿ ಯಾಮಿನಿ ಸಂವೇಶಯ ತ್ವಾ ಕಾಮಂ ಅವಲೋಕಯಾಮಿ ಕೋಮಳಾಂಗ ವಿಗಲಿತ ಗೋರತಮ ಕ್ಷಣಂ ಸದಾ ಕೋಮಲಾಂಗ ವಿಗಲಿತ ಗೋರತಮ ಕ್ಷಣಂ ತದಾ ಸಾ ನಿದನಿ ಸನಿ ನಿದ ಪಮದ ಪಮಗಮಪದನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿದನಿ ಸನಿದ ಪದನಿದ ಪಮಗಮಪದನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿದ ಪದ ಪಮಗರಿ ಸನಿ ಸ ರಿ ಗಮಪದನಿ ಪ ನಗೇಂದ್ರ ಶಯನ ಪಾಟಲ ಬಿಂಬ ಸದೃಶ ಪಾವನ ವಿಮಲಾದರ ಪಾಟಲ ಬಿಂಬ ಸದೃಶ ಪಾವನ ವಿಮಲಾದರ ಹಾಟ ಕೋಪಮ ವಸನ ಹಾರ ಶೋಭಿತ ಕಂದರ ಆಟ ಕೋಪಮ ವಸನ ಆರ ಶೋಭಿತ ಕಂದರ ಸಾನಿ ನೀದಬ ಮಪ ರಿಮಪ ನಿ ಮಗಪ ಮರಿ ಮಪ ನಿ ಸನಿ ನಿದಪದ ಮಪ ನಿದಪ ಮರಿ ಮಪ ನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿದಪದ ಪ ಮಗರಿ ಸನಿ ಸ ರಿ ಗ ಮಪದ ನಿ ಪ ನಗೇಂದ್ರ ಶಯನ ದೇವ ದೇವ ಕೃಪಯಾ ಮೇ ದೇಹಿ ಬಾಹುನಿ ಪೀಡನೌ ದೇವ ದೇವ ಕೃಪಯಾ ಮೇ ದೇಹಿ ಬಾಹುನಿ ಪೀಡನೌ ಭಾವಯಾಮಿ ಭವದೀಯ ಪಾಂಗಲೀಲರಮವರ ಭಾವಯಾಮಿ ಭವದೀಯ ಪಾಂಗಲೀಲರಮವರ ಸಾರಿಸನಿದ ಪಾಮಗರಿಗ ಸರಿ ಸಮಗ ಪಮದ ಪ ಸನಿ ದನಿ ದ ಪದ ಪಮ ಪಪ್ಪ ಮಗ ಮ ಪದ ಪದನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿ ದ ಪದ ಪಮಗರಿ ಸನಿ ಸ ರಿ ಗ ಮ ಪದನಿ ಪ ನಗೇಂದ್ರ ಶಯನ ಮೋದಯಾಮಿ ಜಗದೀಶ ಮೋಹನ ಕಾಮ ಕೇಳಿಷು ಮೋದಯಾಮಿ ಜಗದೀಶ ಮೋಹನ ಕಾಮ ಕೇಳಿಷು ಸಾದರ ಮಾತಯೇನಾಥ ಸಾಮಜವರಗಮನ ಸಾದರ ಮಾತಯೇನಾಥ ಸಾಮಜವರಗಮನ ಸಾ ಸದಪದ ದಪ ಗಪ ಪಗರಿ ಸರಿ ಗಪದ ಸದಪದ ಪಗ ದಪ ಗಪಗರಿ ಸರಿ ಸರಿ ಗಮ ಪ ಗಮಗರಿ ಸನಿ ನಿದ ಪದ ಮ ಪರಿ ಮ ಪದ ನಿ ಸರಿ ಸನಿ ದ ನಿ ದ Now, there is an interesting piece of information about the last two. You see, last one says Bhupalam. I should have pointed out also when I was singing the Varnam, the last raga was Bhupalam. Bhupalam is a lot of people mistake this for they think it's the same as Bauli or Revagupti, which are both Maya Malavagala Janya. Bhupalam is typically considered a Todi Janya. So the Ga is different. A better way to remember that is Ga is like Shivapanturali. Very plain Ga. Ga, Sari Ga. The Ga is plain. Sari Ga. That is Maya Malavagola Janya. So that is what Revagupti and. So it's written in. It's written as Bhupalam, but some people sing it in what is actually Revagupti. But originally, it seems that it was composed in Bhupalam, or Swati Trinal actually used the Hindustani name for it, Bibhas, which is same as the Bhupalam that I just sang. In fact, there is a great song in Bhupalam for sort of Sada Chaleshwaram Bhavaye. There is a Muthuswami Dikshitar song to clearly understand what is Bhupalam as opposed to Revagupti or Bauli. So anyway, so there is that. And then the second one, this has gone through two conversions. It seems that the original composition was in the raga Ahiri, that verse. Then Ahiri, you know, this, by the way, these eight ragas, the song is, each verse is supposed to convey the mood at different parts of the night, the eight parts of jamam or yamam we say. So the eight yamas, so each raga and each verse is supposed to convey the mood for that. So Bibhas or Bhupalam is the raga that is sung just before dawn. That's the time for it. So Ahiri is not a raga that is suitable or not meant to be sung at that time of the early before dawn. So people changed it to Nadanamakriya, which is what you'll see in quite a few books, Nadanamakriya. But in the singing nowadays, M.S. Subbulakshmi has recorded in Maya Malavagola. So that's what many people follow now, Maya Malavagola. In fact, in the one book I have seen, in the one part, it says Nadanamakriya, and when it puts the whole song together in lyrics, but in the swaras, it actually gives Maya Malavagola. So there are some interesting things. How do we know that what was the original? Because there was a copy of this song created, exactly the same ragas, and only thing is it was an lyrics were changed. Everything else was exactly the same tune, all the swaras all same. Pannagadrisha, it's a Telugu song addressed to Venkateshwara. The general guess is that it was composed by Coimbatore Raghavayyar, another great musician, contemporary of Patnam Subramaniyar, Mahavidyanathir and all that. Second half, he was a student of Parameshwara Bhagavatar. So there is a general guess that they might have put these lyrics as a copy of this song. So there we have the manuscript which says the last two ragas as Ahiri and Bibhas. That's how we know that this Pannagendra Shayana probably had those as the original ragas for the last two verses. Vibhas is same as Bhupalam. Swati Trinal has composed, of course, his most famous Ragamalika is Bhavayami Raghuramam, which is in six ragas. But the interesting information is that He did not compose it as Ragamalika. He composed it in one raga only, Saveri all the way. And it is to the credit of Semmangudi Srinivasayyar that we have it as a Ragamalika now, because Semmangudi Srinivasayyar, when he saw the lyrics, basically it was a whole Ramayana. Various khandas in each verse. So he said, you know, typically when a song has multiple charanams and it has only one raga, people usually sing only one of the charanams, most often the mudra charanam, where the composer's name appears. So Srinivasayyar felt that, you know, this is the entire Ramayana. Why should we have only one verse sung? So he made it into a Ragamalika. And that is how it is famous now as Ragamalika. But the original composition was all in Saveri. Now, there is also some reverse thing that seems to have happened. So there is a song, Bhave Sri Gopala. And I looked at Sri T.K. Govindra sir's book. He lists these five Ganaragas. The five Ganaragas being Natte, Gaulai, Arabi, Varali, and Sri. So in his book, he lists this song as a Ragamalika with these five ragas. But the way it is sung nowadays, it's only sung in one raga, Punnaga Varali. Kandachapu. Bhavaye Sri Gopalam Bhava Vinuta Bhavya Sugunalavalam Hridi Bhavaye Sri Gopalam. So I don't know if it was originally composed in these five ragas, Ragamalika, and now it has become a single raga song, or even this five ragas is a later Ragamalika composition. So there's some interesting research to be done there. Then we come to the most monumental composition in Ragamalika. This is the 72 Melakarta Ragamalika by Mahavaidyanathayyar. Mahavaidyanathayyar is considered to be perhaps the greatest singer in Carnatic music ever. People say that he sang like the gods themselves. Brilliant man with great learning as well as a great voice. So a lot of fast brigas, and wherever his imagination went, his voice would cooperate. So he has composed this Ragamalika in the 72 Melakarta ragas. As you know, we have the parent scales. This is a Sampurna Padadi, all Sarigama Padanisa, and different varieties, as I showed you before in the table, different reeds, different gas are there. So we get a 72 combination. So they are arranged from Kanakangi all the way up to Rasika Priya, 72. So he composed this Ragamalika. Originally, it was the lyrics were composed by one person in Tanjavur called Lavani Venkoba Rao. He was also a Mridangam player. So he composed that as a Narastuti in praise of one of the wealthy Maharashtrian people in Tanjavur, Sakaram Sahib. So it was as in praise of him. And he came to Mahavaidyanathayyar to set the tune for it. And of course, he had put the 72 for the 72 ragas. So Mahavaidyanathayyar apparently took only 8 days to do the whole thing. And then he sang in public, and Venkoba Rao actually played Mridangam for that performance. So Mahavaidyanathayyar was paid 2,000 rupees as payment for this work. But he didn't like the fact that it was all Narastuti, praising a human being. So then he made his own lyrics all addressed to Pranathartihara, the presiding deity in Thiruvayaru, which is where he also lived. He was also, just like Patnam Subramaniar, he was also a disciple of Manambuchavadi Venkata Subbayar. And both he and Patnam Subramaniar lived in Thiruvayaru, which is where Sri Tyagaraja lived most of his life. So this 72 Melakarta Ragamalika has another structure. Now in the Mannagendra Chayana that I sang, I should mention to you, where we sang each verse, and then we sang the swara in that raga, and then we did some swara in Shankarabharanam to go back to the Pallavi, right? So that is referred to as Makuta Swaram. These are Chitta Swarams after each verse in that connected to that raga. And then there is a Makuta Swaram which goes back to takes you back to the Pallavi. But then at the end, the last verse, Bhupalam, then we sang all the eight ragas in reverse order, Viloma Swaram, and ending with Makuta Swaram to Pallavi. We did that. So that was one structure. This is what the structure of Nitya Kalyani also was. Now in this Mela Raga Malika, it's different. It's 72 ragas are there. So it starts with actually Sri Ragam, the Pallavi, and then there is a Charanam with 72 ragas in all in order. So of course, it will take a couple of hours to sing the whole song. I'm going to sing just a couple of verses just to point out the structure, and then we will move on.
Pranathartihara Prabhu Purare, Pranathartihara Prabhu Purare, Pranavarupa Sampade Pade, Pranathartihara Prabho Purare, Pranavarupa Sampade Pade, Pranamami Shri Prakriti Prerak Pramata Ganapate Pade Pade, Pranamami Shri Prakriti Prerak Pramata Ganapate Pade Pade, Rigari Rigari Sa Sari Sa Sari Sa Ni Pa Ni Sa Ni Pa Ma Pa Ni Sa Ri Rigari Sa Rima Ri Pa Ma Ni Pa Ni Ma Pa Ma Ni Pa Sa Ni Sa Ni Ga Ri Ga Sa Ri Ni Sa Pa Ni Ma Pa Rigari Ma Tam Tam Takanaka Dim Dim Dimi Dari Gida Taka Dari Gudu Tad Dim Dim Kut Taka Dimi Taka Janu Dari Gida Tam Nadiridiri Dom Diridiri Dittilla Natiranata Nadom Dari Takanaka Taka Janu Taka Dimi Diri Tad Talang Dom Taka Diku Tad Dim Gina Tom Kanakangya Ramaya Pujita Sanakadi Priyakripalaya Kanakangya Ramaya Pujita Sanakadi Priyakripalaya Kanakangya Ramaya Pujita Sanakadi Priyakripalaya Gamagapamadapada Nisa Nirisari Nisa Padadapapamagari Sari Sari Nisa Nisa Risa Nisa Risa Risa Nisa Dani Sari Sa Padani Sani Dani Dapamagratnangya Dharma Samvardhanya Ramana Maam Paripalaya Ratnangya Dharma Samvardhanya Ramana Maam Paripalaya Nidabama pada nisa nidabada nisa nisa ni nisa da nidabada mapaga mapada nidabama gama pada pama pada pa da nisa risa niri risa nisa nidabama gana murti riti
ಧನಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಗಾನಮೂರ್ತಿ ರೀತಿ ಧನಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಗೋಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹವ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ಡ್ ಎ ಕಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಜತಿ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಾಂಗ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದಿ 72 ರಾಗ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಶ್ರೀರಾಗಂ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ರಾಗ ಟು ಅನದರ್, ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕನಕಾಂಗಿ ವಾಸ್ ಸಂಗ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಟೂ ಆವರ್ತಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವರಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ರಾಗ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆವರ್ತಂ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವರಂ ವೇರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಫ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ರಾಗ ಕನಕಾಂಗಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರಾಗ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವರ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರಾಗ ರತ್ನಾಂಗಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅ ಯುನೀಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಲೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವರ. ಅಪ್ಯಾರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಸ್ ಎಲ್ಡರ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಶ್ರೀ ರಾಮಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಶಿವನ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಕೊಲಾಬೊರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಸಿಂಗ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಷನ್ ಬೈ ಮಹಾವಿದಿನಾದಿಯರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕನಕಾಂಗಿ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕನಕಾಂಗಿ ಸ್ವರಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಟು ರತ್ನಾಂಗಿ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್ ರತ್ನಾಂಗಿ ಸ್ವರಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಅರೇಂಜ್ ದೀಸ್ ರಾಗಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೇಳಕರ್ತ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ದಿ ರಾಗಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್, ರೈಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್. ಸೊ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರಿಗಮ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈಚ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ರಾಗಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೀ ಆರ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸಿಯರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿಂಗರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲಿಸನರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ರಾಮಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಶಿವನ್ ಆ್ಯಡೆಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ವರಸ್. ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಪಲ್ಲವಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಈಚ್ ರಾಗ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ರಾಗ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಮೂತ್ಲಿ. ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ರಾಗಮಾಲಿಕ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ 72, ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಕಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಟಿಪಿಕಲಿ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ 6 ರಾಗಸ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಚಕ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ 2 ಚಕ್ರಮ್ಸ್. ಟಿಪಿಕಲಿ 12 ರಾಗಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಸರ್ಟ್. ದಿ ದಿಸ್ ರಾಗಮಾಲಿಕ ವಾಸ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಟಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಬೇಸಯ್ಯರ್, ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾವಿದ್ಯನಾಥಿಯರ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬೈ ದ ವೇ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಸದಾಶಿವಯ್ಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೂ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸೈಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಂಟ್ ತ್ಯಾಗರಾಜ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ಟಿ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ತಿರುವಾದಿ ಆರ್ ತಿರುವಯ್ಯಾರ್. ಸೊ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ there were three co-presidents for the very first music conference in the music academy, and he was one of the co-presidents of that in 1929 or 1930, and then again he was president in 1934. And then when in 1942 when they started giving sangeeta kalanidhis, they gave it to all the previous presidents and he also got it. So he learned this Melakartha Ragamalika from Mahavidyanathayar and then passed it on to his student Musri Subramanyayar. Sabesayar taught at Annamalai University for many years, and Musri Subramanyayar learned it from him, and he would sing in his concerts at least two chakrams of this Melaragamalika. And he passed it on to Srimati M.S. Subbulakshmi, who learnt it from him and then made a recording early 1980s. So that's why we now have the whole Mela Ragamalika preserved, thanks to Srimati M.S. Subbulakshmi. Now that we have heard a few songs, we can now organize all these ideas in terms of the format of the song into different features that we have seen. The first bullet is the most important one. All the others are optional. So each section is in a different raga, of course. Ragamalika has multiple ragas. And section is a broad word. Either it could mean one each verse, like a charanam, in a different raga. Like Pannagendra Shayana, for example. Or it could even mean one line in each raga. Each line in each raga, like we saw the 108 raga tala malika of Ramaswami Dikshitar, each line had the raga and the tala also name in there. It could even be half a line. There are some ragamalikas where that raga only comes for half a line and then the other half is another raga. So the section is a broad word. Raga mudra is quite common in ragamalikas, where the name of the raga is embedded in the lyrics, like Kanakangi, Ratnangi, Gana Murti, Visa. Same thing in the Vishwanatham, Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham, we saw the raga names embedded in the lyrics. So that's quite common. If you embed it like that, then it cannot be changed by later musicians. On the other hand, Pannagendra Sayana, there's no raga names are not in the lyrics. So that's why you have this thing where the last but one verse, if it started out in Ahiri and then changed to Nadanama Kriya and then changed to Maya Malava Gaula. Another feature is Chittaswaram after each raga. Again, these are not essential things, but quite a few ragamalikas have Chittaswaram after each raga. But we will also see some examples of ragamalikas with no Chittaswaram. And then Makutaswaram to return to the Pallavi, where after, like in Pannagendra Shayana, after each raga, in each raga we sing the swara in slow speed and then fast speed. And then we sing the same swara pattern. Sarisa nida pada pa magarisa nisariga ma pada nipan. So that part is called a Makutaswaram to return to the Pallavi. So that is in the raga of the Pallavi. And then Viloma Krama Chittaswaram, where you sing all the swaras and all the ragas in reverse. Like in Pannagendra Shayana, we had eight ragas, and after the eighth one, there were all the eight ragas, swaras and all the eight ragas were sung in reverse to return, and then Makutaswara was sung, and then Pallavi was sung. And in some cases, you might also have Sahitya for those swara portions. Like we saw in Muthuswami Dikshitar's Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham, there was Sahitya for those swara portions. And in fact, some people only sing the Sahitya part and omit the swaras. And this Sahitya could be for the Chittaswaram and also the Makutaswaram. These are the common features that you see in most ragamalikas. But outside of this, we see a couple of additional features in Mahavidinathir's Mela Ragamalika. There was a jati that was put in the beginning. And then there is also this transition swara, transition from one raga to the next raga in the order. This is also a unique feature of this Mela Ragamalika of Mahavidinathir. Another giant, great genius of that time, in fact, a contemporary of Patnam Subramaniar and Mahavaidyanathayar, is Subbarama Dikshitar. He was the grandson of Baluswami Dikshitar. He was Baluswami Dikshitar's daughter's son. Baluswami Dikshitar is Muthuswami Dikshitar's younger brother. So Baluswami Dikshitar's daughter's son, and since Baluswami Dikshitar did not have any any son, so he adopted Subbarama Dikshitar also as his son. So you can see Subbarama Dikshitar being the recipient of many generations of great musical genius. More recently, Ramaswami Dikshitar and then Muthuswami Dikshitar, Chinnaswami, Baluswami Dikshitar, all that converging into the genius of Subbarama Dikshitar. And he wrote this great work, magnum opus, the Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini, that he was tasked by Mudaliyar and Manali. And he was asked to write down everything he knew. And so he wrote down, he took the task faithfully, and he wrote a massive volume which contains 229 kritis of Muthuswami Dikshitar and also compositions of many, many other composers. And also Vagyakara Charitram, he has written biographical notes about many, many Vagyakaras. If he had not written that, we would have forgotten about many of them. So incredible service to Carnatic music. And he did this only in the last few years of his life. This was published in 1904. And so he did this over 2 or 3 years period, a collection of everything that he knew in music. And he is also a music composer. He has composed many compositions. Among those Ragamalika compositions I have written down, there is a 70, he has also done a 72 Melakarta Ragamalika, but this is a different kind of Melakarta scheme. It's called Raganga Ragamalika, which means there are two ways of thinking about Melakartas. Mahavidyanathayar followed the Govindacharya's scheme, which is also what Sri Tyagaraja followed, where it's called a Sampurna Melas, where you go straight Sarigama Padanisa, Sanidhapa Magarisa in the Arohanam Arohanam. There's no Vakra or there's no missing notes, just seven notes going up, seven coming down. This is Sampurna Paddhati. So that's where their names, Kanakangi, Ratnangi, all that comes up to Rasikapriya. Raganga Ragamalika is the Raganga scheme, Melakarta scheme was developed by originally Venkatamakhi. He was the first one who developed this idea of 72 Melakartas. But what he did was he didn't follow this exact that the Arohanam Arohanam should have Sarigama Padanisa. But he allowed, as long as even if you are missing one note, let's say going up, but if that note shows up coming down, then it was considered a full raga and as a parent raga. So this is how you have ragas like Riti Gaula, which is referred to as Nari Riti Gaula in that Katapayadi Sankhya nomenclature. So Riti Gaula, you don't have a pa going up, but the pa appears when you're coming down. So this is a Raganga scheme. So he composed the 72 Melakarta Ragamalika following that scheme. So like that, great voluminous output by Subbarama Dikshitar. And then in the straddling the 19th and 20th centuries, there are these three great music composers whose compositions we sing in today's concerts also very frequently. Mysore Vasudevachar and Harikeshanur Muthiah Bhagavathar and Papanasam Sivan. And each one of them has also composed Ragamalikas. Vasudevachar has composed 10 or 11 Ragamalikas. And in fact, he has composed Ragamalikas in praise of the Trinity also, one on Tyagaraja, one on Dikshitar, one on Shyama Sastri, Ragamalikas. And Muthiah Bhagavathar has also composed five or six Ragamalikas, and so has Papanasam Sivan. And Sri Papanasam Sivan's Ragamalikas, one of them is actually set up in Tirupugal style. They've all made different kinds of interesting contributions to this Ragamalika compositions. Then there is another contemporary of these folks. I couldn't get a picture of him. Nerur Srinivasacharya. I already mentioned him in the Varnams, the Dasaragamalika he had composed in Varnam. So he seems to have been a brilliant genius. He has composed more than 1,000 songs, most of them in Tamil. And he has also done these Ragamalika, 72 Melakarta Ragamalika, and 35 Tala Ragamalika, and 108 Tala Ragamalika. So there are two different ways of thinking about Talas. There is a 35 or 175 Tala scheme, and then there is a 108 Tala scheme. So I told you about the seven Talas before: Dhruva, Matya, Rupaka, Triputa, Jhampa, Ata, and Eka. So those seven talas, then we have this finger counts, they are called laghus. And so there are different finger counts: 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. So depending on the finger count, then the tala is, the number of counts in the tala cycle is different. So 7 times 5, that becomes 35. And then if you also have each one of them in different gatis, meaning how the space between the counts is divided, whether it's divided into 3, 4, 5, 7, or 9, then you get 35 times 5, 175. Anyway, so he has composed a Ragamalika in 35, using 35 talas. And he also done another one, 108, there is also 108 Thala scheme, and he has done 108 Thala Ragamalika, similar to Ramaswami Dikshitar that we saw earlier. So a lot of great contributions by these composers in the 19th century and early 20th century. So, so far, all the compositions I talk about are fairly heavier compositions, and they would typically find their place in the early part of the concert. Not always the case. Some things might also, like for example, any one of these might also come in the later part. But by and large, for example, a Pannagendra Shayana, you could also have somebody singing elaborately a Shankaravaranam Raga and then singing the song in the first half of the concert. And same thing with the Sri Vishwanatham Bhajeham and other things. So, but then, you know, there are songs that I mentioned earlier, like Arabi Manam or Nitya Kalyani. Those might come in the later part of the concert. So there are no hard and fast rules about this. Anyway, so we have seen a few Ragamalikas that were at least composed mostly in the 19th century and early 20th century. So now we let's shift to Ragam Tanam Pallavi, which is in a full-fledged concert, that will be the main item. Of course, there is a tremendous scope for improvisation, manodharmam. So Ragamalika would be readily observed here. Quite often what you see in Ragam Tanam Pallavi is after the Pallavi, Naraval and Trikalam, all that has been done, when the musician is singing swaras, they would sing swaras in different ragas. That is the most, the easiest and the most common way of seeing Ragamalika in Ragam Tanam Pallavi. A little more sophisticated would be also to sing the Pallavi itself in different ragas, and then followed by Kalpana Swaras in those ragas. In fact, my guru Sri T.R. Subramaniam, he would do that. He will sing the Pallavi in different ragas and then swaras, and then he will do, just like those compositions, he will do Viloma Swaram. So he'll sing all the swaras in all the ragas in reverse, all the way coming back to the main raga in which the ragam and tanam were also sung. So there are all these, but this is all manodharma. So we are only interested in the set compositions in this. There are also, you know, if tanam singing, if the Pallavi is in one particular raga, then of course in a vocal concert you will only hear tanam in that raga. On the other hand, if it was a veena concert, you would often hear the tanam not only in that raga, but then followed in the also five ganaraga panchakam, like Natai, Gaulai, Varali, Arabi and Sri. So you will also hear tanam in those. This is quite common in veena concerts, Ragamalika tanam, even if the Pallavi is only in one raga. Now, I should also mention this Pallavi Naraval in different ragas. This sometimes, not frequently, but sometimes this has also been done even in Kritis in the earlier part, when they are doing Naraval on a line. Mostly they would only stick to that raga, but sometimes you might even hear a Naraval that goes into different ragas. I remember one performance by Srimati Aruna Sairam, where the Aadad Asangaduva, that song, Chinnan Chiru Padangal, that line she did Naraval, and then she went on to Naraval in many other ragas, and in doing so, she also indicated other compositions of Uthukadu Venkata Subbayar in those ragas. So, very interesting presentation. So sometimes, rarely, you would also hear Naraval in Ragamalika, even in Kritis. But anyway, these are all Manodharma way of saying. So let's get to the focus on the composition aspect of it. So Pallavi is the only composed portion. Everything else is composed. So there is Pallavi can be in two ragas. It's a early picture of Dr. M. Balamurali Krishna. And so I'm just giving you an example. There are Pallavis, many Pallavis with two ragas. So this one. Anandamrita Varshini Janani Pahi Ma Apar Karuna Kari Sachidananda Bhairavi Anandamrita Varshini Janani Pahimam. Like that, there is a Pallavi that he has sung in two ragas. And this is two ragas. Pallavi is not that uncommon. Then there are also three raga Pallavis. I just thought I would include a modern example by Ranjini Gayatri, where they have this was in honor of their mother. So Saraswati, Lalita and Durga, they have composed and sung this Pallavi in three ragas. So when you have ragas and when you have Pallavi in multiple ragas, then that also gives you scope for more raga alapana and tanam also in those ragas, right? So you have raga alapana in three ragas or two ragas, and then tanam also in those ragas. That also gives scope. And then similarly, four raga Pallavis. This is, of course, the very famous Pallavi. Four raga Pallavi. Shankarabharananai Azhaithodi Vaadi Kalyani Darbaarukku. Ariyakudi Ramanujengar popularized it. And Sri K.V. and K.V. Narayan Swami sir also used to sing it.
Shankarabharanai Azhaithodi Vaadi Kalyani Darbaarukku Shankarabharanai.
So, very enjoyable Pallavi, and of course, gives scope for alapana, all four ragas, and so on. Now, this Pallavi was created by Kunrakudi Krishnayyar. He was a contemporary of Mahavidyanathayyar and Patnam Subramaniyar, Subram Dikshitar, and all. So, in fact, he was considered. They used to refer to the second trinity, so to speak, after the trinity of Saint Tyagaraja and Dikshitar and Shyama Sastri. They used to refer to a second trinity, and that was Mahavaidyanathayyar, Patnam Subramaniyar, and Kundakudi Krishnayyar. So he was a genius, and in fact, some of his Varnams, there's a very famous Kamboji Varnam that he has composed, and so on. So some of his compositions are still in vogue. Now, something very funny about that, his name, Kundakudi Krishnayyar, is the basic name. But if I were to give a full name with all the descriptions of him, it would go something like this. Ghananaya Desya, meaning, you know, there are three ways of singing. Ghanam, singing Ghanam, heavy, or Nayam is softly, and Desyam is light, singing with the ragas, like North Indian ragas and all that. So he was an adept at all three, it seems. Gananaya Desya Retta Pallavi. He would have, he would typically sing Pallavi, that not single avartam, but Pallavi, that would be actually almost like two Pallavis put together. So one Pallavi leading to another Pallavi. He was referred to as Retta Pallavi Krishnayya. And Murukku Meesai. So, meaning he had long whiskers, which is very rare for, you know, all these I mean, musicians would be all, they would not have mustache. So he had apparently a long curly mustache. It's Murukku Meesai, he was called, Krishna Iyer. And he's referred to as Jigibigi Krishna Iyer. Jigibigi, what it means is that he loved, you know, most of the musicians of those days, they wear very simple clothes. They were simple minded. But he liked to dress up in very fine clothes and with a lot of perfume and everything and makeup. And so he used to stride like a royal person or something. So people used to call it Jigibigi Krishnayir. So Gananaya Desiya Retta Pallavi Murukku Meesai Jigibigi Kundrakudi Krishnayir. That was his full name, it seems. So this Pallavi, this is of course in four ragas, and in the Manodharmam, when you're singing Swara also, you can, a nice way to sing Swara is, you sing Swara in Shankarabharanam, end in the place where Shankarabharanam word comes, and similarly you end the Todi Swara in the place where Todi's word comes. That's a more intelligent way of singing Swaras for this Pallavi. Another interesting thing, this is not a strictly a Ragamalika composition. So this is a very famous Pallavi. Nattai Kurinji Enbar Siranda Yengala. This was Alathur brothers and Sri K.V. Narayan Swami sir. They all used to sing this. Nattai Kurinji Enbar சிறந்த எங்களது நாட்டை குறிஞ்சி என்பார். This is the famous Pallavi, நாட்டை குறிஞ்சி obviously. நாட்டை குறிஞ்சி என்பார். So, குறிஞ்சி is one of the plants in Tamil country. So, சிறந்த எங்களது நாட்டை குறிஞ்சி என்பார். That's one word. நாட்டை குறிஞ்சி song is. So therefore, you can immediately see where to take this. Sri T.N. Seshagopalan sir, when he sang this Pallavi, he sang it in three ragas. He sang in Nattai, sang in Kurinji, and then he sang it in Nattai Kurinji. So this, even though the Pallavi was originally a single raga Pallavi, he made it into a three raga Pallavi like this. And therefore, also the raga, alapana, also in the three ragas and swaras and everything. So, there is no limit to creativity. And and our musicians have explored things in so many different ways. So, this is just, Rantana Pallavi is mostly about Manodharmam. But there are also Ragamalikas in the... In the composed, even single line of Pallavi, there is a Ragamalikas, and people have explored that. After Ragam Danam Pallavi, people also refer to it as post Pallavi session, where you will have lighter songs such as, Padams, Javalis, Kirtanas, Bhajans, things like that. They are generally also referred to as Tukkadas. It comes from the Hindi word tukda, small pieces. So there are lots and lots of Ragamalikas, as you might imagine. So this is where you will hear a lot of these songs that original lyrics were by somebody else, and then they have been tuned by later musicians. For example, older composers like Purandaradasa, Narayana Tirtha, Annamacharya, their songs have been set into Ragamalika song. For example, Purandaradasa is a famous one. Chandra Choda Shiva Shankara Parvati Ramana Nene Nage Namo Namo. This is popularized by Srimati M.L. Vasanthakumari. So, and then Ninyako Ninna Angyako Ranga Ninna Namada Bala Undidaresako Ninyako. This is also a very famous Ragamalika. This actually tune was made by my guru Sri T.R. Subramani. So like that, and Narayana Tirtha, you know, and there are lots of songs that have been said in Ragamalika. Yanta matramuna yamvaridala china. This M.S. Subbulakshmi has sung this, Ragamalika. That's Annamacharya's. Narayana Tirtha, I already mentioned, Jaya Jaya Gokula Bala, which was in Kurunji, and then Thiruvatriyutta Agayar made it into Ragamalika, starting with Bhairavi. And then similarly, the next generation of composers, Uthukadi Venkata Subbayyar and Arunachala Kavi Kavirayar, their songs in Tamil, they've all been set to music only by later musicians. Uthukadi Venkata Subbayyar's, many of his songs were set to music by Nidamangalam Krishnamurti Bhagavatar, his descendant. And some of them have been set in Ragamalikas. And similarly, Arunachala Kavirayar, he was, of course, a lyricist. And then even in his time, he had a couple of people who composed the music for his Ramanatakam. But they were all reset into more modern tunes by Arikudi Ramanujayengar and others. So there is there are some Ragamalikas. There is one very famous Ragamalika. எனக்குன்னிரு பதம் நினைக்க வரமருள்வாய் ஸ்ரீராமச்சந்திர எனக்குன்னிரு பதம் நினைக்க வரமருள்வாய் இது ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் இன் கல்யாணி மிஸ்ரச் சாப்பு ஸோ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ராகமாலிகா அண்ட் தென் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் சுப்பிரமணிய பாரதிஸ் சாங்ஸ் தெர் சோ மெனி ஆஃப் தம் ஹவ் பீன் செட் இன் டு ராகமாலிகாஸ் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் சின்னஞ்சிறி கிளியே தீராத விளையாட்டு பிள்ளை திஸ் வாஸ் டன் பை ஸ்ரீ லால்குடி ஜெயராம் திஸ் டியூன் அண்ட் லைக் தட் தெர் ஆர் மெனி ஆஃப் தம் சாங்ஸ் தட் ஹவ் பீன் செட் இன் ராகமாலிகாஸ் ஸோ ஆஸ் ஐ செட் ரைட் இன் த பிகினிங் வி வுட் நாட் பி ஸ்பெண்டிங் மச் டைம் ஆன் தீஸ் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ராகமாலிகாஸ் பட் வி வாண்ட் டு ஃபோக்கஸ் ஆன் சாங்ஸ் தட் வர் கம்போஸ்ட் ஆஸ் ராகமாலிகாஸ் ஸோ மூவிங் ஆன் தெர் ஆர் கப்புள் ஆஃப் great ragamalikas that are still popular today by of course one of the greatest vocalists in Carnatic music Sri GNB sir and tik theriyada kaattil wonderful ragamalika of course the lyrics are by Subramanya Bharathi and in Sri GNB's golden voice and but there is one that he himself composed
சொன்னதை செய்திட சாகசமா கிளியே
தட் சாங் இஸ் ஸ்டில் வெரி பாப்புலர் ஸோ ஃபோர் ராகாஸ் அண்ட் லுக் அட் த ராகாஸ் வந்தன தாரிணி ஜெயந்த ஸ்ரீ தேவமனோகரி அண்ட் மாண்ட் ஸோ வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் தீஸ் டூ ராகமாலிகாஸ் ஆர் ஸ்டில் வெரி பாப்புலர் And then, of course, D.K. Pattammal popularized many Ragamalikas. This one is particularly very famous.
Velan varu varadi.
This was a composition of Anayampatti Adisheshayya. And it has multiple ragas, as you can see.
Vadi velan varu varadi. வேலன் வரு வரடி
வெரி பாப்புலர் சாங் அண்ட் தென் ஐ ஷுட் மென்ஷன் நவ் இன் டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் லிரிக்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் பீங் செட் இன் ராகமாலிகாஸ் அம்புஜம் கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி கிரேட் லிரிசிஸ்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் 20th சென்ச்சுரி மெனி மெனி கிரேட் சாங்ஸ் அண்ட் விச் ஹவ் பீன் டியூன் பை மியூசிஷியன்ஸ் இன் டு வேரியஸ் very famous songs and some of them are ragamalikas
kannanidam eduthu solladi
this is a famous ragamalika that Srimati M.S. Subbulakshmi used to sing this and then behag
கானமழை பொழிகின்றான்
you would have heard Sri T. N. Seshagopalan or other things and of course Sri T. N. Seshagopalan's tune
Kannava Manivannava
very popular Ragamalikas of with the lyrics from Srimati Ambujam Krishna. Now, this one, I want to focus on some songs where Raga Mudra is there, name of the Raga is there in the lyrics. So, Arabi Manam, I already mentioned to you, a very famous song that is still popular today. Tarangampadi Panchanadiyar, who was this disciple of Subbaraya Shastri, the son of Shyama Shastri. So, from the 19th century, it is still popular. And it has 12 songs, 12 ragas, and in each verse, the four ragas, there is a Viloma Swaram, and then going back to Arabi. Now that's one route where the Vilomam happens within the Charanam itself. Now Tanjavur Shankarayyar did the other kind of Vilomam, which we have already seen in Muthuswami Dikshitar, where all the way back to Pallavi Swara. So Ranjani Ragamalika, he took four Ranjani Raga, meaning ragas ending with the name Ranjani. Ranjani, Sri Ranjani, Megha Ranjani, Janaranjani, those four ragas he took. Simple lyrics and then swaras. So first starts with Ranjani and then using swara, and then Sri Ranjani, and then using the swara for Sri Ranjani and also Ranjani, and go back to Pallavi, and then the third one, then you know, Megha Ranjani, Sri Ranjani, and Ranjani, and then Janaranjani, Megha Ranjani, Sri Ranjani, and Ranjani. So it's a reverse order, Viloma Swara. He exploited that. A very famous Ranjani Ragamalika. Ranjani Mrudu Pankajalochani Ranjani, right? You all would have heard this. Now, then we come to a composition of my guru, Sri T.R. Subramaniam, who did this reverse in a much more complex way. He composed Manohari Ragamalika, meaning all ragas ending with the name Manohari. And like Arabi Manam, it has 12 ragas, meaning three verses. There is an opening verse, and then there are two more verses, four ragas in each one of them. And each time the swaras in Arabi Manam, as I said, you sing the swara for that charanam, and then you go back to the Arabi Manams. In this case, you sing four swaras and then the four swaras of the first one. And then the third one, you sing basically all 12 swaras in the reverse order and get to the Pallavi. So you can see musicians just building on each other's ideas and making things far more complex and enjoyable. I'm going to sing this Manohari Ragamalika. Since many of you may not have heard that.
Inbamellam tarum Manohari, Inbamellam tarum Manohari, Idaya kamalam vaalum Kamala Manohari, Idaya kamalam vaalum Kamala Manohari, innamudam surakkum Isha Manohari, innamudam surakkum Isha Manohari, iniya vetri serkum Jaya Manohari, iniya vetri serkum Jaya Manohari. Gari gamadasa madarisa sanidama, gari gamada gama gari gasaridasa sari gari ri gamapa gamapada nisa nidapada mapa magari gasa sagamapa gamapa ni gamapa nisa sagamada sagasa nidapani mapa gamapa padasa sadapa mamapa pamagari gama dagari sada dari sada dasada sada inbame Lam taru Manohari, Nesamudan no kum mecha Manohari, Nesamudan no kum mecha Manohari, Nadi tuyatir kum
லலிதா மனோகரி நதி துயர்த்தீர்க்கும் லலிதா மனோகரி இசையே வடிவான சரஸ்வதி மனோகரி இசையே வடிவான சரஸ்வதி மனோகரி ஈசன் இடம் கொண்ட கௌரி மனோகரி ஈசன் இடம் கொண்ட கௌரி மனோகரி ரிகமப்பாதனி சரிகமகரி சரி நிசாதனி பதமபகாரி சனி பாமகரிக சரிக சரிகமத சரிகமகரிக சதனி பதனி சசனி பமகரி சசகமபதனி சகமகரி சபதனி சனி பமகரி ககமககத ககனிதனி சரிகமகாரி சனிதமகாரி ச கரி கமதச மதரிச சனித மாகரி கமத கமாகரிக சரிதச சாரி கரி ரீ கமப கமபதனி சனித பதம பாமகரிக ச கமப கமாபனி கமபனி ச சகமக சக சனித பனி மப கமப பதச சதப மமப பமகரி கம தகரி சதரி சதத சத சத இன்பமெல்லாம் தரும் மனோகரி தமோ குணம் நீக்கும் ரமா மனோகரி தமோ குணம் நீக்கும் ரமா மனோகரி தேவர் குறை தீர்த்த தேவ மனோகரி தேவர் குறை தீர்த்த தேவ மனோகரி சோம சுந்தரர் மகிழ் கந்தர்வ மனோகரி சோம சுந்தரர் மகிழ் கந்தர்வ மனோகரி சாந்த நல்வாழ்வருள் வசந்த மனோகரி சாந்த நல்வாழ்வருள் வசந்த மனோகரி ரிகம கமத மத நிதனி ச ரிகமகரி சானிதம மகரி ச பசாரி மகரி சனித மாரி மா பச சனித மனித மகரி சரி மபதனி மபதனி சரி மசரி சனிதனி பமரி மசரி சரி கமபத கமபதனி பதனி தச சனி நித பமகரி சரி கமப்பாதனி சரி கமகரி சரி நி சாதனி பத மபகாரி தனி பாமகரி க சாரி க சரி கமத சரி சரிகமகரி சதனி பதனி சனி பமகரி சகம பதனி சகமகரி சபதனி சனி பமகரி ககமகத ககனிதனி சரிகமகாரி சனிதமகாரி ச கரி கமத ச மதரி சனித மாகரி கமத கமாகரி க சரித சாரி கரி ரீ கமப கமபதனி சனித பதம பாமகரி க சகமப கமாபனி கமபனி ச சகமக சக சனித பனி மப கமப பத சதப மமப பமகரி கம தகரி சதரி சதத சத சத இன்பமெல்லாம் தரும் மனோகரி இதய கமலம் வாழும் கமலா மனோகரி இன்பமெல்லாம் தரும் மனோகரி
சோ தட் வாஸ் மனோகரி ராகமாலிகா.
Next, I want to also talk about another great composer, N.S. Chidambaram. Many, many compositions, brilliant composer, lots of great songs. And some of them are many of the musicians sing his songs. One of the great Ragamalikas by Sri Chidambaram is Nidan Thunai Nilambari. It's a very simple, if you just take the structure of the song, it's just... eight ragas, verses, lines in eight ragas, Pallavi in two, Anupallavi has two, and then Charanam has four. Simple. What made it great was, of course, the work of Tanjavur S. Kalyan Raman, sir. He made the song into a really fantastic composition. I'd like to sing just the basic outline of the song. This is in Misra Chapu, by the way. Nidantunai Neelambari Neelakandan Manogari Nidantunai Neelambari Neelakandan Manogari Nidayavai Yenai Yadari Nirmalavasanta Bhairavi Nidayavai Yenai Yadari Nirmalavasanta Bhairavi Nidantunai Neelambari ஆதாரமாய் உலகனைத்தும் ஆண்டருள் கௌரி மனோகரி ஆதாரமாய் உலகனைத்தும் ஆண்டருள் கௌரி மனோகரி பாதார விந்தம் பணி சரஸ்வதி பாடி போற்றிடும் பரமேஸ்வரி பாதார விந்தம் பணி சரஸ்வதி பாடி போற்றிடும் பரமேஸ்வரி நீதான் துணை நீலாம்பரி மாதா மனம் மகிழ்ந்தருள் தர இன்னும் வாதா மறை புகழ் ஸ்ரீரஞ்சனி மாதா மனம் மகிழ்ந்தருள் தர இன்னும் வாதா மறை பொருள் ஸ்ரீரஞ்சனி மதியணி சங்கரனின் மனம் கவர்மானினி கதி நீயே மோகன கல்யாணி மனம் கவர்ஷம் மதியணி சங்கரனின் மனம் கவர்மானினி கதி நீயே மோகன கல்யாணி மதமிகு மகிஷனை மாய்த்திட வதம் செய்து மகிமையுற்றமாயே ஸ்ரீ துர்கே மதமிகு மகிஷனை மாய்த்திட வதம் செய்து மகிமையுற்றமாயே ஸ்ரீ துர்கே மாந்தர்தம் தூயரிருளை அகற்றிடும் மங்கள ஜோதி ஸ்வரூபிணி மாந்ததம் தூயரிருளை அகற்றிடும் மங்கள ஜோதி ஸ்வரூபிணி நீதான் துணை நீலாம்பரி நீல கண்டன் மனோகரி துணை நீலாம்பரி. So this eight raga Ragamalika simple song, in Sri Kalyan Raman's hands, it became a massive work of art. What he did, he sang all the eight ragas in Alapana, and not just as, you know, bits, eight bits, no. You will see them, they are all so well integrated. All the eight ragas are so integrated in the raga alapana. It creates a structure that is all as if not eight separate parts, but really one integrated whole. So he develops the ragas in slow speed, and then the fast phrases, it just brings them together very nicely. And then the song is sung, and then of course Kalpana Swaras. Swaras he sings in each raga, going to the right location of that raga name to end the swaras. And then he does a finally one big korappu pattern, where just reducing the length of the swaras in the different ragas. First a full line, then half a line, and so on. It's one of the most delightful works of art in Carnatic music, in my opinion. And of course, there is a recording in YouTube, which is a live recording. Unfortunately, Sri Kalyan Raman's voice, he was coughing a lot in that recording, so you won't get the full effect of it. You should try and get hold of the commercial recording that he made. And I believe the violin was by Ms. Kanyakumari. And it's just one of the most magnificent pieces of art. How he shaped this song, Nidan Tune. Another very well-known Ragamalika of N.S. Chidambaram is Karunai. Karunai Madhi Thavarum Jagan Mohini. There's one song like that. And he has also got a Ranjani Ragamalika in 12 Ranjanis. Just like Arabhimanam, so there are three verses of four lines each, so four ragas each. And then he's also put swaras for this. So there are the swaras in reverse, not all 12, but 4, 4, 4 like that, like in Arabhimanam. So this is the Ranjani Ragamalika, the great T.M. Tyagarajan sir enjoyed singing this song. We have been talking about composers. Now I want to very briefly mention a couple of musicians who have done incredible amount of work in terms of popularizing Ragamalikas. And of course, the number one among all of them is Srimati M.S. Subbulakshmi. She's popularized numerous Ragamalikas. I already mentioned several of them already. The 72 Melakarta Ragamalika, and like that, there are many, of course, Stotra literature, Bhajagovindam, many, many, Balaji, Pancharatnamala, there are so many of them. And one of the early ones that I used to enjoy so much in the growing up in the 1960s was this very famous Vadavarayai Mata Ki Vasukiyai Nanaki. Some of you old timers might remember this song. This is actually a song from Silappadigaram by Ilango Adigal. So it's describing, of course, Krishna's Leela and or Mahavishnu in general. And so this song, she sang, I think in the 1960s, she made this recording, was so popular in those days. And then another decade afterwards, she made this recording, which is still evergreen, Kurayonrum Illai. This was a composition of lyrics were by Sri C. Rajagopalacharya Rajaji. So there are many, many great Ragamalikas, thanks to Srimati M.S. Subbulakshmi. And another musician in recent years who used to really love singing Ragamalikas in his concerts, always would have some Ragamalika in the second later portion of his concert, was Sri Maharaja Paramsantana. You all would know these songs. Sarangan Margane Saveri Balakane, right? So this is, every line, this is what I meant. So half a line, the one raga going on. So this is a composition of Yarpanam Veeramani Ayyar. I'll have more to say about him soon. Brilliant man, Yarpanam Veeramani Ayyar. And then another famous composition of Ragamalika song that Sri Santanam used to sing is Nalina Kanti. This is in Kandacha. Nalina Kanti Mati. So this was by Madurai V. Krishna Swami. And then another one he used to sing, Ragatil Siranda Ragam. ராகத்தில் சீரந்த ராகமெது கல்யாணிய காம்போஜிய ராகத்தில் சீரந்த ராகமெது He used to sing this. There's some string of, I think, 30 ragas or so in this song. And this was composed by Kadalur Subramaniam. Kadalur Subramaniam is another brilliant musician. He used to sing in his heyday. He used to be considered as a worthy replacement for Sri GNB himself. When he would sometimes sing, he would sing like that, just incredible brigas, just like Sri GNB. And so he used to sing and hold his own in that realm, in that milieu. And there are many other Ragamalikas that Sri Santanam sir used to sing, such as Sri Chakra Raja Simhasanir. Of course, everybody knows that song. And Tunga Tira Virajam and Kshirabdi Kannike. Again, a great Ragamalika, many ragas. Kshirabdi Kannike Sri Mahalakshmi ಯಾರಿಗೆ ವಧುವಾಗುವೆ ಮಹಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ವಧುವಾಗುವೆ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಸುಟ್ಟುಂ ವಿಳಿಚುಡರ್ ಸುಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣ್ಯ ಭಾರತಿ ಸಾಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ದರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಮೆನಿ ಹಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಲವ್ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ರಾಗಮಾಲಿಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಮ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫನ್ ಯಾಳ್ಪಾಣ ವೀರಮಣಿ ಅಯ್ಯರ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಡೆಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಒನ್ entire slide to his song Karpagavalli. And this is perhaps among Tamilians perhaps the most well-known Ragamalika. Of course, it comes under the devotional songs category. Sri T.M. Soundararajan's great voice made the song. I mean, everywhere in Tamil Nadu you would hear the song in the 60s and the 70s. So it starts with Anandabai. கற்பகவல்லி நின் பொற்பதங்கள் பிடித்தேன் நர்கதியருள்வாயம்மா It's a four ragas. Just the song. No other, you know, all the features that I mentioned. In this, these are the songs that I'm talking about now. I just have the lyrics in charanams. That's all. Charanams in different ragas. No additional swaras or anything like that. But incredible song. Very popular. And this Yaazhpanam Veeramani Iyer, as the name indicates, he was from Yaazhpanam or Jaffna in Sri Lanka. And he was he studied at Kalakshetra and he learnt music from the great stalwarts. Particularly, he was inspired by Sri Papanasam Shivan. And so he took after him in terms of composition. Many, many compositions. His songs are sung by many musicians. And this Karpagavalli Nin was, of course, one of his most famous. He was also, being in Kalakshetra, trained by Srimati Rukmini Arundel in dance. So he had produced a lot of dance items, dance dramas and all that. And so he has composed music for dance as well as for Carnatic concerts and devotional singing and so on. Really a great man. One of the 20th century great composers. And of course, Sri T.M. Soundararajan, one of the golden voices in the Tamil movies in the 20th century. And he gave voice to this song and made it immortal. Also, before we leave, I want to point out some recent compositions that are remarkable. One is by Sri Chitravina Ravikiran. He has composed a Geetam, 72 Melakartha Ragas. This is a very interesting composition and valuable for learning for students. Now, I'll point out how the Geetam is organized. So, it is organized along the line of the 72 Melakartha. So, as I showed you this before, there are these 12 notes. And depending on, sometimes you might use Re and sometimes you might use Ga, so that you make sure that the Re is not higher than Ga. So we would not have Re 3, Ga 1, for example. So we would use these alternate names for these Swarasthanas, for these 12. So from this, you can make 12 From these 12, you can make 72 combinations, and that's where you get the 72 Melakartas. For example, let's start with the Ma 1 and Ma 2. And so if you fix Ma, let's say at Ma 1, and then you look here, there are 6 possible combinations. As long as Ri is lower than Ga, there are 6 combinations possible with one Ma. And then for one Ri and Ga fixed, then again there are 6 combinations of Da and Ni possible. So that's how you get 6 times 6, 36, that is for one Ma, another 36 for Ma 2. So that makes 72. So this Gitam that he has composed, what you do is, so each chakram, the first half, that line will be Sarigama. So the first Sarigama, and then only Padanisa is different. Instead of singing Padanisa, he will, the name of the raga is put in there, Kanakangi, Ratnangi, Ganamurti, like that. So Sarigama will be maintained here, and then in the Padanisa, the name of the raga is put in there. So it's a very interesting compositions with a lot of educational value as well, and very nicely done. Another very remarkable recent composition is by Miss Kanyakumari. She composed 108 Ragamalika, and in fact she has presented that with 100 musicians on stage as a big instrumental ensemble. So the it has a Pallavi which has got lyrics and in copy, and then a string of 107 ragas in various charanams. Very attractive Pallavi. Tirupati Venkatesha Kripa Kara Daya Payo Nidhe Alamel Manga Sahita Srinivasa Tirupati Venkatesha Kripa Kara Daya Payo Nidhe Alamel Manga Sahita Srinivasa Tirupati Venkatesha Kripa Kara Daya Payo Nidhe. This is a Pallavi. So only the Pallavi has lyrics. Everything else, all the charanam have swaras, but in each so each charanam there are swaras in 6 ragas. So but in each swara portion of that raga ends with the raga name. So the raga name is put in there. Valaji, the first one starts with Valaji, and so on. The raga name will be there at the end to end the swara portion, so that you know which raga is being sung. And there are some rare ragas as well. And then in the we return to the Pallavi in the 6th raga. We don't return to the Pallavi in Kapi. We return in that the 6th raga. So like that, there are multiple charanams, but the last charanam is in 17 ragas. Because you know, one of the ragas for 108 already has been taken up by Pallavi. So the last charanam, instead of 18, it's 17 ragas. It ends with Madhyamavati. And so, and then just like this, we return to the Pallavi in Madhyamavati. And then comes the climax, where she does a final Korappuswara, you know, the pattern, rhythmic pattern, where you do it 3 times and then do the grand finale. So in that Korappuswaram, so 2 rounds are in Madhyamavati, and the 3rd round is in Kapi and comes back to the Pallavi Tirupati Venkatesha. So really a beautiful composition, 108 Ragamalika. It's an all in Aditalam. Other recent compositions that I have enjoyed, there is one by Sri Surya Prakash, Devargal Arul Seidha Rahangale. So starts in Hamsanadam. Devargal arul seidha ragangale andha bhavathil thoindha paadalgale ragangale paadalgale, like that it goes. So it's an Hamsanadam. And then the thing is, Then in the all the subsequent lines in the charanams and so on, it has 30 ragas. So the raga name is embedded in the lyrics for each one of them. And not only that, very intelligently, a popular song in that raga is also indicated through those lyrics. For example, the first line, Nattai Paripalanam Sei. So Swaminatha Paripalaya song is there. So like that, each raga, he puts the raga name and also indicates a popular song in that raga. Very delightful composition by Sri Surya Prakash. Another notable composition is by my friend Sri Kandikeshwaran in Cincinnati. So he has composed the Dasavatara composition in 11 ragas. And in Jampatala, I know the Misra Jampatala has got 10 counts. So that's the connection, the Dasavatara. As a dedication to, he's inspired by Muthuswami Dikshidhar, so it's in Sanskrit, and Guru Guha Namanam, and the words come, so he bows down to Sri Muthuswami Dikshidhar through this composition. So these are all, as you can see, many of these compositions, although this one, the Savatara song, is somewhat on the heavier side, and in Sanskrit, but most of the other ones I mentioned are fairly... they choose a set of light ragas, and so they are more suitable towards the later half. But there is no hard and fast rule. You can make a song as heavy as you want by adding raga, lapana, niraval, swaras and all that. Then, of course, we are not done with the concert, right? So these are all the post-Pallavi lighter tukkadas. Then we come to Tillana and then Mangalam. So in Tillana, there are a couple of remarkable ragamalikas. Both by Dr. Ambala Murali Krishna, one of the great geniuses and one of the greatest vocalists in the history of Carnatic music. And first one is a Grahabeda Ragam. He also refers to it as Taya Ragamalika. So I mentioned to you about Grahabeda Varnam by Charumati Ramachandran. Same way he has done through Grahabedam, you get these different, I have indicated. It starts with Kalyani, which is on Sa, and then if you shift the Sa to Pa, you get Shankarabharanam. And then if you shift to Re, of course, you know, Mohanam has only 5 notes. So he doesn't shift all, use all the 7 notes all the time, but a subset of notes to create even these 5 note ragas like Mohanam Indolam. And then Darbari Kannada. So he has done Grahabedam Ragamalika for this Tillana. So Tanum num dadara Tillana Tadara dani dana tagum dari kita taga Tanum num dadara Tillana. Like that, opening Kalyani, and then goes to other ragas. Very delightful. But you know, when you're singing Grahabeda, of course, the violinist will also have to cooperate and know that, okay, you are moving to this swara as your Adhara Shadjam, and he has to move to that swara and play there, sapasa there. And so it makes it easier for the vocalist to then move on to the other raga and then return back to the original scale. So this is a remarkable composition. It's Ragamalika for Tillana. Another very remarkable composition is Gati Bheda Priya Ragamalika. So first one is Grahabeda, this one is Gati Bheda, and this is Priya Ragamalika. First of all, Priya means it has 5 ragas. All of them have Priya in their name, and this is Gati Bheda. So Gati, as I mentioned before, the space between two beats, you can divide it up into 3, 4, 5, 7 or 9. So he does this in this order. So starts with the Chaturashra Gati. So it is a Gati Bheda also, and then there is a Priya Ragamalika. So the opening Guru Priya is a unusual ragam. Tritom na 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 tom na 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 tom na 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 din na dr din na dr din na dr dom. Udanadanadr tom na 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 tom na 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 tom na 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 dinnadr 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 dom. Udanadanatari ditari tom tari nam tari ujanu tajanu tijanu sanida magari ni sarigama hridayamuna nilipinati ma sadguru priyamaina tillanad tom nanana tom nanana tom nanana dinnadra 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 tom. Very unusual phrasing also, and this raga of Guru Priya is also not that common, and then followed by other Priya ragas, and each one is in a different gati or nade. So two very remarkable Ragamalika Tillanas by Dr. M. Balamuli Krishna. Okay, finally ready to close the concert. Mangalam. Even in Mangalam we have Ragamalikas. There is one by Krishna Swami Aiyya. Mangalam Mangalam Meenakshi Tejaya Mangalam. And I mentioned to you right when I was talking about Muthuswami Dishitar, this one, Simhasana Sthite, which is also a sung as a Mangalam, because it has the Mangala Ragas and Mangale Mangale, it comes several times. So I will also close with this song as a Mangalam, this presentation.
Simhasana sthite sundara guru guhanuta lalite. Simhasana sthite sundara guru guhanuta lalite. Chidanandanatoham vandeham vandeham. Simhasana sthite sundara guru guhanuta lalite. Chidanandanatoham vandeham vandeham. Tom takanatajam nidadapa tom takanatajam pamadani sari pamadadiginatom pamanidadadiginatom tanom dadirana tapamadanisa tanom tadarasungasana sthite. Brahmadi sakala devata radita padayugale. Brahmadi sakala devata radita padayugale. Parashuram bhagavat pramukopasita bagale. Parashuram bhagavat pramukopasita bagale. Jantakanidam jantakari sanidhim tillanadam janutagatam sanidanida tattitalangudom dagajanutalangudom takadimitagajanutalangudom asana sthite. Kamalesh nuta mangale kavi jananata mangale. Kamalesh nuta mangale kavi jananata mangale. Mantrini dandini samuhadi mangale. Mantrini dandini samuhadi mangale. Dittillana magapamaditla ukkundari mapanidaditla. Tattayam apanidani saritarigidadom tam sanidavatarigidadom tam rimapanitarigidadom simhasana sthite. Ayagriva kumbhajadi
pujita nitya mangale haya griva kumbhajadi pujita nitya mangale niratishaya shubha mangale navanavavida mangale niratishaya shubha mangale navanavavida mangale sarini sadintanadiranna nadrudimipa neemtiranna nadrudim nibanidiranna kitadimapanidiranna tanadimdiranna tanadirana dirana simhasana sthite sundara guru guhanuta lalite chidanandanathogam vandeham simhasana sthite. So there are actually two or three versions of this song also. There is one version where there are no swaras or anything, just the straightforward lyrics. There's one with just a chitta swaras, and then this is the version I sang has also about jati and swaras. Probably came from dance. So there are like that evolutions even within the compositions over the over a period of time. Musicians with their creativity add things to the original compositions also, even when they are set as Ragamalikas. So thank you for listening and for your attention, and hope you will find great joy in continuing to listening to Ragamalikas and other aspects of Carnatic music as well. Thank you.